hey, I'm having a California moment. Here it comes. If you're from California, you'll want to go to California. Don't steal. Don't lie. Don't cheat. Don't do bad things. But the government there, they hate the competition, right? They're just bad. They're all over the place. They're trying to wreck the state, and they're doing a good job of it. Think of sunshine places like Venezuela and so many other countries down there in that part of the world. And over time, with socialism, they're ruined. They're just totally ruined. And California is on that path. Firstly, a quick one about guns, ammunition. You know, gun owners in California, everywhere for that matter, typically they're conservative individuals. And in California, there's about 16 million of them, I understand. And so the government there, the commies, they're knocking them every time they get a chance. And it hasn't worked that well because you have the Second Amendment. So they're saying, hey, let's go after the ammunition. It's kind of like if you want to ban cars, what do you do if people won't let you? Close the gas stations, okay? So what they've said is we're now starting July 1st, 2019, we're going to have background checks as a requirement before you all can get ammunition. Doesn't matter if you're licensed and you're legal and you've had all the background checks. Even yesterday, you have to have a background check every day if you're buying ammunition every day. It can be intimidating. Nobody knows yet how long it will take, but probably a few hours. I have licenses in California. I have guns in California. And to buy a gun, wow, what a process. I mean, you sit there for hours and hours out of your day, and gun shops typically are open during the day, and most people typically have work, right? They have a job, so it's difficult. And now they're doing it with ammunition, trying to beat everybody down, Proposition 63. You know, politicians who actually support gun control should not get armed protection paid for by those they want to disarm. And in California particularly, the governor and all of his cronies, guess what? They have people around them with guns all of the time. That shouldn't be allowed. In California, their population has grown from 29 to 39 million people over the past 30 years. Wow. However, each year, there's a net loss in migration to other states. I mean, how can that be? Their growth, though, comes from mostly illegals and certainly some legals. People, Latinos from across the border, okay? And the population is of the Latino population is responsible for that. 27% of the state's residents were not born in America. Latinos now make up 40% of the state's population. They now outnumber white people, and guess what? Latinos vote mostly Democrat. So it's kind of like they're building this thing in, you know, just so they can really become like Venezuela sooner than later, and it's happening. No matter where you go, go to San Francisco, where the governor used to be mayor. I mean, it's a disaster. There's needles everywhere, and people are living on the streets, and they can't find work, and it is totally out of control. Venezuela, I can't say it enough. I mean, it's coming to a place near you. Los Angeles now, they have close to 20,000 people living in their cars, right? These are people that can't find work and they can't afford to have an apartment because of the politics of the state. I mean, it is that bad. And now they're saying, let's put together new bureaucracies to go out and kind of like an RV park and to create, of course, we will own it, we'll buy it with rich people's money, parking lots. And then we'll charge people to park the cars there. But hold it, they're homeless because they have no money and they're in their car. Now you want to charge them 30 or 40 bucks a night. I mean, it's just another train on the tracks, and you know that it's going to get wrecked. Okay, California now is set to become a real welfare zone. I mean, they bring in everybody that's illegal. We're a sanctuary state. Come on down. Who pays for all of this? The rich people do, but they don't believe. They be in the Democrats. They don't believe in rich people unless it's them. So they want everyone to leave. I guess, I don't know, because they keep taking the money from the rich people to give it to other people. That's called theft, isn't it? And now they're saying, in the first phase of this at least, we're going to provide full health benefits to a select group of illegals. What kind of a message is that? Can you imagine raising your kids and they watch this on television and that? They're illegals and we have these benefits. In their $213 billion, with a B, dollar budget, they've put in this little wee chip here, which is called $100 million as a cost for this small little group of 90,000 low-income illegal immigrants. And that's just the first step. And y'all know that. There's going to be another one, another one, another one. Everyone's going to get free because they're getting it now, right? In so many different ways. Where does the money come from? Venezuela. Oh, and yet they have the beautiful sunshine. It's a wonderful state. You drive around and you think, how can this be? All these white liberals who hate their country, hate their fellow countrymen, I must have a guilt complex or something. I don't know what it is. I mean, it's all about activity, I guess. No achievement unless you call destroying a state achievement. I mean, it is craziness. Robert Mueller, he was unable to clear the president of any wrongdoing, okay? Which is not how the justice system is supposed to work. You know, if you use that standard about having no proof, I could say that I have no proof that the governor is of California is a coke addict. I've yet to find proof that he doesn't use crack. What a thing to say. I've yet to have proof that the guys at CNN don't molest children. I don't have proof to that. What a terrible thing to say, even for me. But you get it, right? I mean, what kind of a standard is that? You know what? In terms of politics and our country, things are tough. I mean, we'll get better because a lot of us are tougher. And thank goodness we have the president and so many people like him that are pushing to the right. But here it is. The only easy day was yesterday. Say, see you tomorrow.